So we're continuing our series on the importance of grip strength because of how it's associated with your total body strength, your life expectancy, and your quality of life. Now, last week we looked at how farmer carries can help with carrying things and why your grip strength is important for being able to pick things up and carry them. Now we're going to look at just how to pick them up. So your grip strength, obviously, when you have to pick anything up off the floor or pick something up, you know, off the stairs, again, it's all about your grip strength and how you brace your core and your lower extremities to balance that weight. So using deadlifts is a great way to do it. Difference between a deadlift and a squat is really just the placement of the load. If the load is below your hips, it's a deadlift. If it's above your waist, it's called a squat. So we're going to look at two different ways you can do it. If you just have dumbbells at home, that's fine. And we're going to do a paired leg deadlift first. So holding the dumbbells, flat against your thighs. Again, keep your head up, chest up, neck neutral, which means it's not hyperextended or flexed, just in a straight alignment. And then always start with the hips. The hips are always the part of your body that leads the movement anytime you're going to sit, squat, or do a deadlift. So my arms are staying relatively straight. A lot of people want to put their arms out forward because they don't want to hit their knees. Really, as long as you're doing this correctly, you shouldn't have to move your arms at all. Just stay straight, and then I move my body around my arms. And then all you have to do is go take your hands down just below your knees. And again, you're moving your hips first. It's hips, then knees bend. They'll flex automatically along with it. That's using a dumbbell. If you're gonna use a barbell or a larger bar, you can do two different grips. You can do a pronated grip with my palms facing back. And again, same position as I just did with the dumbbells. My back straight, chest up, and my neck in a neutral position. Again, my arms are not moving. I'm not having to extend my arms out in order to do this. And also, you don't want to scrape your shins along with it either. So you can do a pronated grip, or you can do an alternate grip, which is a stronger grip, because now for me to drop this, it would take a lot more effort. So then, same position as if you're doing the pronated, just below your knees, right down in that soft spot, just below your kneecap, is where you're gonna end up with that movement. So again, deadlifts are a great way to do this. That was a paired leg movement. Coming up in the next segment, I'm gonna show you how to do a single leg deadlift. And we'll see you soon.